Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Okay, in the last session we have discussed about measurement of electrode potential of a different electrodes by using a reference electrode, that is a standard hydrogen electrode. That is, we considered by constructing a galvanic cell, the electrode whose potential to be determined is coupled with the sheath, and we are going to construct a galvanic cell with the help of the relation E cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. So by using the formula, it is possible to determine the electrode potential of a other electrode. Well, during discussing about electrode potential, we mentioned two kinds. One is electrode potential, another one is standard electrode potential. So we know the difference between these. That is, electrode potential means, there we said, whenever a metal is in contact with its own ionic solution is considered as a single electrode, and the potential developed is considered as a single electrode potential, or simply it is electrode potential. On the other hand, what we said, when a metal is in contact with the one molar solution of its own ions, then potential developed is considered as a standard electrode potential. Well, so we specified concentration. In electrode potential, we have not specified concentration of the solution taken, while in standard electrode potential, we specified concentration of a solution. It means there will be a relation between potential developed and concentration of a solution. As well as, even while dealing with the electrode potential, we are not going to specify temperature of a measurement, but while dealing with the standard electrode potential, we are going to specify temperature as a 298 Kelvin. It means, what I am going to say is, so there is a relation between these three quantities, that is electrode potential, concentration of the solution taken, and temperature. So mathematically, the relation among these, the mathematical relationship between electrode potential of an electrode, the concentration of the solution, and temperature of measurement is given by Nernst in the form of a Nernst equation. So in this session, we are going to discuss about the Nernst equation and some other concept. Well, coming to the Nernst equation, so what it is? It is an equation, a mathematical equation, which gives the relation between electrode potential, molar concentration of the solution, and temperature. So Nernst, he gave a mathematical relationship between those three quantities, that is electrode potential of an electrode, concentration of the solution, and a temperature. That mathematical expression is called Nernst equation. So I repeat, Nernst equation is nothing but it is the equation which gives the relation between electrode potential, molar concentration of solution, and temperature is called Nernst equation. Well, mathematically, what it is? It is indicated as E cell is equal to, so simply I say E is equal to E naught. We know the difference here. E means cell potential, E naught means standard cell potential. So E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 2.303 RT by NF log of reduced form divided by oxidized form. So instead of reduced form to the oxidized form, simply one we can say product to the reactants, concentration of product to the concentration of reactants. Well, or else say this sign can be changed. By changing the numerator to the denominator, denominator to the numerator. So what is the other form? E is equal to E naught, E cell is equal to E naught cell plus, instead of minus I am taking here, plus 2.303 RT divided by NF log of. Now we have to change numerator to the denominator, denominator to the numerator. So log of oxidized form divided by reduced form. So is the mathematical expression. It is called Nernst equation. So what is Nernst equation? The equation which gives the relation between electrode potential, molar concentration of solution, and temperature. So mathematically, how we can write? So E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 2.303 RT divided by NF log of reduced form divided by oxidized form. Well, coming to the terms involved. So what are the terms here? So what is E? As we said, it is the electrode potential of a electrode. What is E naught? E naught is the standard electrode potential. Then what is N here? N is the valency of metal or non-metal. Here N indicates the formula. This N indicates the valency of metal or non-metal, or else even we can say number of electrons transferred. Number of electrons transferred during a reaction. Further, what is F? F is Faraday. And we know the value, 1 Faraday is equal to 96,500 coulomb. Then what is T here? T indicates absolute temperature. It is expressed in terms of Kelvin. And R indicates the gas constant. So R indicates the gas constant. And what is the value? 8.314 joules per Kelvin mole. So it's regarding Nernst equation and the terms involved in it. Well, coming to the different forms of a Nernst equation. So Nernst equation can be given for both metallic electrodes as well as non-metallic electrodes. Well, whenever if I consider nature of a metal, as we say, generally metals are electropositive in nature, or in turn I can say metals are highly reactive in nature. So metals, if I consider, usually what type of reaction to be specified? A reduction reaction to be specified. Means metal ions, by accepting one or more electrons, they undergo reduction. So generally, if I consider reduction reaction, say Mn plus plus n number of electrons gives rise to M. So for metals, we are specifying a reduction reaction. If it is the case, so what is the product here? Metal. What is the reactant? Mn plus. So for this general equation, the Nernst equation will be E is equal to E naught minus 2.303 RT divided by NF log of product divided by reactant, reduced form to the oxidized form. So metal to the metal ion, concentration of metal divided by concentration of Mn plus. Or else further, that sign can be changed. So what is the equation? E is equal to E naught plus 2.303 RT divided by NF log of concentration of metal ion to the concentration of metal. So here, what is the concentration is for pure metals. So what it indicates? Concentration of a pure metal. So the concentration of our pure metal is taken as unity, is taken as 1, is the consideration made in the Nernst equation. For our pure species, their concentration is taken as a unity. Therefore, this equation changes. So E is equal to E naught plus, now if you substitute value of these 8.314, that is R value, and temperature is taken as 298 Kelvin. So 2.303 into 8.314 into 298 divided by, what is the Faraday value? 96,500. So if we simplify these, what is the value we get? 0.0591 divided by N log of concentration of Mn plus. So is the equation used to calculate the electrode potential of a metallic electrodes. So overall, what you can say here, Mn plus indicates square bracket Mn plus, which indicates the concentration of that species. So generally it is indicated as a C. So if I consider Nernst equation for metal electrodes or metallic electrode, what is that equation? E cell is equal to E naught cell plus 0.059 divided by N log of a concentration of that ionic solution. Or else even we can say E cell is equal to E naught cell plus 2.303 RT divided by NF log of concentration of metallic ions. Well, is the equation for metallic electrodes. Similarly, coming to the Nernst equation for non-metallic electrodes. Nernst equation for non-metal electrodes. Well, if there is a non-metal, in that case, well, non-metals, they have a tendency for accepting one or more electrons. So by accepting electrons, they readily fulfill their octet configuration. So we used to say they are electronegative in nature. They are electronegative in nature, so that they accept one or more electron readily, so that get converted into their respective ions by fulfilling their octet configuration. So non-metal, say A is a one general example of a non-metal. A, by accepting n number of electrons, get converted into A raised to n minus or minus n. Okay, well, for this general equation, if I want to write the Nernst equation, so what we are going to get? E is equal to E naught minus 2.303 RT divided by NF log of concentration of reduced form divided by concentration of oxidized form. So concentration of A N minus N divided by concentration of A. Similarly, here also concentration of pure species, concentration of pure non-metallic species is taken as a unity. Therefore, equation changes to, so at 298 Kelvin, so E is equal to E naught minus 0.0591 divided by N log of concentration of A raised to minus N. Or else, generally what I can say, E is equal to E naught minus 0.059 divided by N log C. So for metallic species, what we got? E is equal to E naught plus 0.059 by N log C. For non-metallic electrodes, the equation will be E is equal to E naught minus 0.059 divided by N log C. Well, it is regarding Nernst equation and a Nernst equation for metallic electrodes as well as non-metallic electrodes. I hope it is clear for you. Then coming to the Nernst equation for a Daniell cell. We know that Daniell cell, yes, is a well-known example of a galvanic cell. It has two half cells, zinc electrode and copper electrode. So that for Daniell cell, if you wish to write the Nernst equation, well, here, so first individually we write individually for both the half cells. For zinc electrode, so in the Daniell cell, the electrode potential for any given concentration of copper 2 plus ions and Zn 2 plus ions at any concentration, okay? So at cathode, what is the cathode there? Copper electrode act as a cathode. Cathode means, what is the reaction involved there? Copper. Well, what is the reaction involved? Copper ions undergo reduction. Copper 2 plus, by accepting 2 electrons, they undergo reduction. So, if I consider that reduction, so Nernst equation for copper electrode. So, cell potential of copper electrode is equal to E naught of copper minus RT divided RT by NF ln. Instead of log, we are taking here ln. So, RT by NF ln of 1 by Cu2 plus. Okay. Similarly, for anode, what is the expression? So, cell potential of zinc electrode is equal to E naught Zn, that is a standard electrode potential of zinc electrode, minus RT by NF. Here, how many electrons involved? 2 electrons involved. So, we are taking 2 here in both the case. So, 2F ln of 1 by Zn 2 plus aqueous. So, cell potential, we know that cell potential, E cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. That is, E cathode means, what is electrode? Copper electrode. Cell potential of copper electrode. So, E copper electrode minus cell potential of a zinc electrode. So, E zinc electrode. So, if you substitute these quantities, if you substitute and simplify, what we get? E cell is equal to E naught cell minus RT by 2F. RT by 2F ln of concentration of Zn2 plus divided by concentration of copper 2 plus. It is the Nernst equation for a Daniell cell. Further, even we can, instead of writing ln, what we can write? We can write 2.303 log. So, by converting it into logarithm form, as I said, instead of taking ln, what we are taking here? Log. And what is the temperature we are specifying? 298 Kelvin temperature. So, E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 2.303 RT divided by 2F log of concentration of Zn2 plus divided by concentration of Cu2 plus. Further, if I substitute the value of R and T as well as F, what we get? E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 0.059 divided by 2 log of concentration of Zn2 plus by concentration of Cu2 plus. It means by knowing the concentration of both the solutions, whatever the in a Daniell cell, whatever the solution, zinc sulfate solution and copper sulfate solution, by knowing the concentration of both the solutions, we can get the cell potential of that Daniell cell. Okay. So in general, so it is regarding Daniell cell representation of a Nernst equation. So in general, if any kind of, for any kind of cell, say if the general reaction, if it is the general reaction, say A of A plus B of B gives rise to C of C plus D of D. So it is a general reaction. So for any kind of general reaction, how we can write a Nernst equation means E cell is equal to E naught cell minus RT divided by NF ln of concentration of C raised to C into concentration of D raised to D divided by concentration of A raised to A into concentration of B raised to B. I hope you can recall this while dealing with electrochemistry. I hope you have studied reaction quotient as well as equilibrium constants. What that reaction quotient says? It is the ratio. Reaction quotient is nothing but the ratio of product of concentration of products, product multiplication, product of concentration of product to the product of concentration of reactants, and all concentration terms raised to their respective reaction coefficients or stoichiometric coefficients at any stage of a reaction, at any stage of a reaction is referred as reaction quotient. Okay, it is indicated as QC. So here ln of QC is taken. So the ratio of product of concentration of product to the product of concentration of reactants, all concentration terms rise to their stoichiometric coefficients. So what is necessary to write Nernst equation means it is necessary to know the balanced chemical equation as well as N value, that is number of electrons involved. So if you have a balanced chemical equation and if you know the number of electrons transferred, yes, one can write the Nernst equation for such kind of reactions. So it's regarding generally how we can write Nernst equation means, so E cell is equal to E naught cell minus RT by NF ln of concentration of product to the concentration of reactants, all concentration terms rise to their stoichiometric coefficients. Well, then coming to few examples, say first example, so we specified here cell reaction. So what is the cell reaction? Zn plus 2H plus gives rise to Zn2 plus plus H2. First we have to look for whether the reaction, given equation, is balanced or not. If not, we have to balance it. So things to be remembered here is, to write a Nernst equation, necessary thing is we should have a balanced chemical equation. Further, we should be aware about number of electrons transferred. Okay, well, whatever the given equation is a balanced one. How we can check? We have to simply check the number of species on either side. So 1 mole of zinc, 1 mole of zinc, 2 mole of hydrogen, 2 mole of hydrogen. So number of species are equal on either side of equation, so I can say it is a balanced one. Now when I look at the equation, what I can say, zinc converted into Zn2 plus, it means zinc is undergoing oxidation, so it acts as a oxidation half cell. On the other hand, H plus ions are converted into H2. H plus plus 1 to 0. What happens here? There is a decrease. So we can say H plus ions are undergoing reduction. So it acts as a reduction half cell. H plus ions is nothing but it is a sheet. So here zinc electrode acts as anode and hydrogen electrode acts as a cathode. Well, how we can represent the cell? And how? Well, the cell representation is oxidation half cell, Zn slash Zn2 plus aqueous salt bridge HCl slash 2H2 slash platinum. So is the cell representation. So during the reaction, how many electrons transferred here? 2 electrons. So N is equal to 2. So we have a cell representation as well as number of electrons. So by using this data, we can write a Nernst equation. So E cell is equal to E naught cell minus RT divided by 2F. So N is equal to 2. So we are taking 2F ln of concentration of Zn2 plus divided by concentration of H plus. Products Zn2 plus into concentration of H2 is taken as unity divided by concentration of Zn into concentration of H plus raised to 2. So H plus raised to 2, concentration of Zn is taken as a unity. So overall, what is the equation we got? E cell is equal to E naught cell minus RT divided by 2F ln of a concentration of Zn2 plus raised to 1, stoichiometric coefficient is 1 here, divided by concentration of H plus raised to 2. Why 2 means here stoichiometric coefficient is 2. So if I consider temperature at 298 Kelvin, if I specify temperature as 298 Kelvin, then equation will be E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 0.059 divided by 2 log of concentration of Zn2 plus divided by concentration of H plus raised to 2. Coming to the second example, say here what is the reaction involved in a cell? Nickel plus 2Ag plus gives rise to nickel 2 plus plus 2Ag. So equation is given. Write the Nernst equation for a given equation, they will ask. Say some chemical reactions will be given. So by using that chemical reaction equation, we have to write the Nernst equation. So in the second example, I have specified nickel plus 2Ag plus gives rise to Ni2 plus aqueous plus 2Ag. Here also, again, once again, you have to look for the given equation is balanced or not. Well, in this case also, 7 mole, 1 mole, 2 mole of Ag, 2 mole of Ag. Well, this equation is also balanced one. So balanced equation. Now, when I look at the reacting species here, nickel and is get converted to Ni2 plus. It means here nickel electrode is undergoing oxidation and it acts as a oxidation half cell. On the other hand, Ag plus converted into Ag means silver ions are undergoing reduction. Reduction in the sense that silver electrode act as a cathode. So how many electrons are being transferred? 2 electrons are transferred. So N is equal to 2. Well, cell representation, oxidation half cell, that is nickel electrode, Ni solid, interface Ni2 plus aqueous, salt bridge, reduction half cell silver electrode, so Ag plus aqueous gives rise, slash Ag. So is the cell representation. Then coming to the Nernst equation, say E cell is equal to E naught cell minus RT divided by NF ln of concentration of product. So concentration of Ni2 plus into concentration of Ag raised to 2. But we have not taken here. Why? It is a pure species whose concentration is taken as a unity. So concentration of Ag means 1. 1 raised to 2. Again it is 1 itself. So we have not considered here. So concentration of Ni2 plus alone we have taken, divided by concentration of Ag plus raised to 2 into, if I take concentration of nickel, again it is also pure species, whose concentration is taken as a unity. So overall equation will be E cell is equal to E naught cell minus RT by NF ln concentration of Ni2 plus raised to 1 divided by concentration of Ag plus raised to 2. So most of the students, they fail to recognize the stoichiometric coefficients. Without balancing equation, if they write the Nernst equation while dealing the numericals, they are going to end up with the wrong answers. Okay, so you have to concentrate balancing equation before writing Nernst equation. Well, so for the, say if I specify temperature at 298 Kelvin, cell potential for given cell reaction, so E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 0.059 divided by 2 log of concentration of Ni2 plus divided by concentration of Ag plus raised to 2. So is the Nernst equation for given cell reaction. Well, similarly, we go for one more example. So if the cell reaction is, say, 2Al aluminium, 2Al plus 3Ni2 plus gives rise to 2Al3 plus 3Ni nickel. Now here, again, look at the reacting species. Al converted into Al3 plus, Ni2 plus converted into Ni. So here, aluminium is undergoing oxidation, Al to Al3 plus, while nickel ions are undergoing reduction, Ni2 plus to Ni. Therefore, what we can say, aluminium electrode acts as anode, while nickel electrode acts as cathode. Now, when you consider number of electrons transferred, say 1 mole of aluminium converted into or oxidized to Al3 plus by releasing how many electrons? 3 electrons. How many moles of aluminium are there? 2 moles, means totally 6 electrons are being liberated at an anode. During oxidation, what happens? 6 electrons are liberated. Well, if I consider reduction reaction, say 3 moles of Ni2 plus converted into 3Ni. So each Ni2 plus consumes are reduced by 2 electrons. So totally 6 electrons are used for reduction. Therefore, what I can say, what is the N here? N will be 6. So 6 electrons are transferred from oxidation half cell to reduction half cell. Therefore, we have a balanced equation and N is equal to 6. So what is the cell representation? Aluminium slash Al3 plus salt bridge Ni2 plus slash Ni. Okay. Further, Nernst equation, E cell is equal to E naught cell minus RT divided by 6F. As N is equal to 6, so 6F ln of Al3 plus raised to 2. Stoichiometric coefficient Al3 plus raised to 2 divided by Ni2 plus raised to 3. Further, at 298 Kelvin, the cell potential will be E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 0.059 divided by 6 log of Al3 plus raised to 2 divided by Ni2 plus raised to 3. So it's regarding few examples for which we can write the Nernst equation. Okay. So, I hope it is clear for you, that is Nernst equation for metal electrodes, Nernst equation for non-metal electrodes and few examples, okay. So, in the next session, we discuss about some other concept of electrochemistry. Well, thank you.